Welcome back to Let's Play Ambermoon Blind for your Commodore Amiga personal computer system. I am Amethyst Lutatari. We just freed the people from Burnville, along with freeing Captain Torl, who's going back to Spannenberg, who has a gift for us. Maybe he's going to give us a boat, or at least a boat ride or something like that. Been looking for him for a while, as we were looking for Sabine for a while in Valden. We just kind of ran into him. I see the last prior episodes for the story of Valden here. It comes from the game Lionheart, which they broke the fourth wall and then kind of promoted the game in this game. So it's starting to get dark out. It's 8:25 p.m. We do need a little... You know, we really don't need much, I don't think. We'll let Nelvin hold all the rations. We need to get more. We only have 22 for 6 people. It's gonna go fast. So let's just camp here outside the tower and... Then we'll head out in the morning. Should be able to see better in a moment. Unfortunately, the only way I know how to get back is the way we came. That's much better. Now this is gonna hurt, isn't it? Can we step across on the rock? Oh, excellent. Otherwise, I think we would have got hurt there. We can use the rock to step across. Awesome. I like that. I did not know that you could do that. Okay. And then... Is there anything this way? Oh, another one of these broken... I think these are broken wind gates. You think something would pop up describing something? Oh. Alright. We could take the ship right here. If we had one. There's no raft waiting here for us. Alright, so let's go back to that cave entrance. Ah! We missed a rock! Hopefully these... Nothing in here has returned. Wait, I thought I clicked that. No charges left, okay. Dropping. Whee! Let's drop a save just in case things do come back. Don't think they would. Otherwise, I'd rest to get our points back up. Life points. So we gotta walk through all this. Kind of annoying. I have to go south from here. It's a dead end. Around out that door. If I turn here or go forward. I think I'm facing that way. Now I'm going back. Let's just see where I am. Head the right way again. Okay, I need to keep this wall to follow this wall to my left. Don't let it get out of my sight. And from here, it looks like we're facing that way. Now I want to follow the wall on my right. See the door out. Hey. All right, saving again, just in case something horrible attacks us. We don't have to walk through all that again. Let's get back to Burnville. If I can find it. In dark again. Alright, let's camp. Oops. Okay. Now that's the way back to the raft. Here we go. Yay! We made it. Burnville! The non-Burnville. Life has returned to Burnville, and all those who survived imprisonment in Luminor's cells have returned and are working hard to repair the fire's damage. Once it's no longer burned, You're gonna change the name? Get back here. I would have words with thee. One of the town guards examines you carefully and says, "Welcome to Burnville. I am sorry that I must check on you, but since the matter with Luminor, we need to be very careful." No, I totally understand. Now, there's other houses that... I still want to look around. So we've got the artist's house, that's just all these different ways inside. Merchant, food, we need food. Chapel, healer, bathhouse, and blacksmith, and a tavern. I think there might be other houses that are just, you know, not places to go. They're not stores and such. Well, there's someone over here in the little, what used to be a forest. A young man with long blonde hair welcomes you and says, "Hello everyone, I am sorry, but I have no time for a long chat. I must prepare myself for a great journey. I want to go to the large forest island east of here. The master of the forest is supposed to be looking for a new apprentice. You need to know there are strange Zenobel trees in the forest on that island. Their wood is so valuable that even a single stick is worth more than even the whole town of Burnville." Okay. I'm going to write that down in case you might want to get some Zenobel tree wood. Sounds lucrative. Okay, so... large... forest... island... east of Burnville. Zenobel trees. Wood valuable! Exclamation mark. So noted. Thank you for your information. Wait, is that a door? It does look like a door. Is that another way into the tavern? I don't know. Let's try to go in. Cactus Inn. I like the song. An old man with a sunburnt face speaks to you. "I am very happy to meet the Burnville heroes personally. Although I am very old, I am very happy to have been saved so that I could spend a few more years in our wonderful world." Let us talk to everyone. So don't get descriptions of these people. A small, fat man wearing a black leather apron says, "Ah, our saviors! Welcome, welcome. Without you, I would never have seen my inn again. So I have just told my staff you can stay overnight for just one piece of gold per person. I hope you have a restful stay." That is quite a bargain. Thank you. You have anything in these barrels I could relieve you of as well? One more barrel right in front of me. Just in case. Okay. And who are you, fair lady? A young woman carrying a large tray full of glasses says, "Welcome to the Cactus Inn. If you're thirsty, sit down. If you need a room, please register in the room next to the kitchen." Okay. Hail. A young warrior wearing the uniform of the town guard says, "We have doubled the number of guards at Burnville so that nothing this terrible can ever happen again. Personally, I think it would be better to use cunning and intelligence to fight a stronger opponent rather than always just getting more equipment." Welcome, what brings you to my fine inn? I'm not going to rest yet because then it's going to be nighttime, right? And I want to talk to these people while they're up and about. In there now. Right, here be the kitchen. Oh, so they have an upstairs as well. Guest rooms. Well, I guess we rest and we wake up here. We'll come back here when we're ready to rest. Okay, so yeah, that answers our question. There is two ways in. I'm just going to walk around in case there are other places I can get into that don't have the little fast travel mark on them. Because I thought there were a couple that looked like just people's houses or something. Could be wrong. See any doors here? All right, so this is the blacksmith. Maybe we can sell some things here. Oh, to repair something. Well, we don't have any broken stuff on us, at least I don't think so. So he only repairs things. We could bring our compass and things here, maybe we can repair that. Is this the same guard? Oh. A warrior meets with you and you get into conversation with him. He says, "I will probably go to Ilion and take on a job at the town guards there. The elves of Ilion are having problems with Sansri, the goddess of the snakes." Oh, very familiar. "For this reason, they desperately need people to help them." Alright, so there. Sansri we came across in Amberstar. So I'm writing this down. Ilion. You don't really get into it. Problems with Sansri. Okay. My little notepad. Because you do not have a quest log or journal, what have you. and Ambermoon. Or Amberstar. Okay, this is the bathhouse. This should be interesting. Welcome! Do you want to improve your swimming? Oh! Burnville Swimming School. That's all this does is improve your swimming. Huh. No, I don't want to use any points on that. I thought I was going to walk around in a bathhouse. Like a sauna. How disappointing. There's nothing here. The healer, we're gonna go last. Let's go to the chapel. So this is the chapel. There's a door for the healer. And nothing else. Okay. The house of the healers. Nice pillows. Very tranquil until you run into stuff. And an ouch happens. Hello. I cannot see that far. I need glasses. A young healer woman stands before you, carrying a pail of bandages in her arms. She says, "Ah! Here are our saviors. Everyone is so happy that Luminor's terror is at an end. Apart from those who are badly injured, who we are looking after here, all the others have gone back to their normal lives in the town. Now please excuse me, I must change some dressings." You're excused. Not pretty cool, we're the saviors before... She's protecting what's in this wardrobe here. Can you see that? Right, let's see. Take a look. Probably nothing. Nope. What is this? This person seems to be asleep. Oh, is it getting late? I think it's getting late. Can't look, no books. Right. Yeah, it's dark out. Who's this old guy here? Let's go back to the inn, but first... Awfully a lot like the skittish old man in Spannenberg. Whoop. Sorry, I didn't mean to smash into you like that. An old man with a long beard starts a conversation with you. "Welcome, welcome. I have only just returned from New Lake and can only say, if you want to go there, you must visit the main library. It is a fantastic fountain of voyage for anyone." Alright. That's, encouraging, actually. I don't know when we're going to New Lake. As it is, we got the large forest island with Zenoble trees and Ilion as well to check out. Alright, so let's go back to the tavern. Rest for the eve. 6 gold pieces. Sold. So yeah, we do end up there. Alright, people should be up again. That's that same guard. I want to make sure I don't miss anybody. Oh, he's the one who checks on us. Okay. I commend you for your diligence. Back to the chapel. I see these people when they're actually awake. Now what, I ran through here, right? There's probably an easier way around, also. Ah, the person's asleep because they're ill. That must be why. Right. Oops. Okay. Checking around in case there's any, like, little hidden knickknacks. And finding nothing. I think that goes back outside. It does. There's the old man watching us. Next to the door ahead of you hangs a small brass sign, all kinds of healing. Welcome. How can my healing powers assist you? They cannot. It looks like heal stupidity. Maybe this is resurrect. I don't know what these things even are. Healer of Burnville. About in here. The door before you is a small brass sign, Library of the Healers, Magic Scrolls for Healing. Welcome to an extend your knowledge of magical spells. Okay, so this is for our Sabine, our healer. Remove blindness, remove disease, neutralize poison, medium healing, destroy undead, holy word, wake the dead. Great healing, remove rigidness, heal aging, wake up, remove irritation, remove drugged, you can be drugged in this game, restore stamina, okay. Some of this stuff is kind of appealing here. Great healing. It should say here, like, the spell learning points you need to, you know. Well, thief can use it, too. Like, what spell learning points you need. But we must consult this, then. If it shows up, and then... So was it called Great Healing? Probably a different name here. Major Healing, probably. You need 30 spell learning points. I think she has 29. Let's see. 48. That said, I don't know... I don't think she's ready for that yet. I mean, she can only cast medium healing twice. Yeah, we need 100 spell points. Well, 30 spell points. Okay, so she can... Spell point's only 127. So she can only cast it once. I don't know if we should even buy it for later. It'll clutter up our inventory. So let's see what she does know. Let's see if she knows any of these. Okay, so she has remove blindness, remove pain, remove poison. Relieve pain. Relieves pain for a group member. I guess that's something like a debuff that can just happen to you on top of actually losing life points. Just having pain. It's good that she has that. And heal blindness is remove shadows. Remove shadows is for one group member. Heal blindness is for everybody. Okay. We have remove fear, which in this case is probably reduce panic. So we have that. So what about disease? Cures the group of diseases. So we don't have a single for disease. Because everything else has, you know, one group member, all group members. Cure poison we have. And this stuff is beyond her reach right now. I don't know if he even sells that. Major healing. So you know what? She could use cure disease then. We also have rouse, which is okay. Let me write this stuff down, because that wakes people up. You think as you go on, it's getting harder and harder, right? But then we have this stuff, relieves stiffness. It'd be a good idea for her to, like, know all this stuff. Stiffness. Heal paralysis. Yeah, this stuff doesn't cost a lot. She's probably not going to be able to learn all of them. And then what's the one up here? Cure disease. The poison I wouldn't even bother with. We have so many potions of it. But she already knows it, right? Yeah, remove poison. Okay, so then down here, heal aging. This stuff could become a problem later on, so. Stone to flesh. Actually on Valden's amulet, stone to flesh. But I'm not completely sure if we're keeping him, if we come across somebody more awesome. We might switch him out at least temporarily. He is a pretty cool character. He has really good stats and such. Eliminate confusion. Oh, and then the drugs thing. Isn't too much to cast. Alright. Eliminate confusion. And then neutralize drugs, looks like just from one group member. And then cure madness. And strengthen. Should I be able to learn all this? Perseverance. Okay. Because she has 30, right? And her read magic is pretty good. So she wears her spell learning price 48, actually. So this one, cure disease, is 10. Oh, we have revival, which is like a mass healing. Look at how that's written. Mass healing increases the LP of all group members to the maximum at most. And then mass healing. Yeah, it's beyond her. This is a full heal for everyone. That's the one right there. So it's 150 to cast it. So, and then 10 here, so it's 20. Heal aging, 32. Stone to flash we can wait on. Rouse, 37. And then eliminate confusion, 42. And then these would have to be unknown. Stone to flesh should be unknown. Until she gets that. Okay. But I think whatever we have, just buy it now.